examination and therapy for the musculoskeletal pain from Academy of Orthopedic Manual Physical Therapists, AOMPT. Remember the traditional thought, this is the take-home message, two slides, okay? So we have a traditional thought where all neck pain is cervical spondylosis, all the shoulder pain is periarthritis, all the elbow pain is lateral epicondylitis, and all the knee pain is osteoarthritis, okay? And the next one, structurally, remember that articular or myofascial or neural could be leading to the symptoms. The symptoms can be local symptoms or it can be referred symptoms, okay? What is referred symptoms? They are located at a place far away from the structure that is affected, okay? And functional, if you are differentiating in the pain mechanisms, whether it's the role of the central nervous system or it is the peripheral mechanisms for the pain. In central, we have the central sensitization and also we have the cognitive affective, okay, the psychosocial ones. In peripheral only, sympathetic nervous system is there, peripheral sensitization is there, and nociceptive is there, okay. Articular differentiation, you differentiate the joints that are related to that area, which can refer the pain to that region, okay. If it is shoulder, then I will differentiate between the four joints, be it scapulothoracic, acromioclavicular, or it is the sternoclavicular and the glenohumeral. Okay. And then next one, of course, the myofascial differentiation, where I will differentiate between synergists. Okay. I will differentiate between agonist and the antagonist for their strength, which is underactive or overactive, length, which is shortening or lengthening, and mobility, which is the myofascial play. Neural differentiation, differentiate by their physiological dysfunctions and also by their mechanical dysfunctions. Okay. In central and peripheral mechanisms, remember that organic and non-organic. I was telling you an example of religious belief or spiritual or what is called as emotional relationship with the pain. That is non-organic, called as malingering. Organic one is called as the pain plasticity, okay? Representation of the brain in the brain. Okay. Peripheral mechanisms, nociceptive is because of the free nerve endings in the structures. Example like menisci do not have free nerve endings, so they are not actually pain sensitive. But menisci is attached by ligaments, okay? Menisci is attached to the capsules where those are pain sensitive, okay? Neuropathic is the nerve related pain that is from the nerve or from the adjacent structures. Biomechanical differentiation, you can differentiate them kinetic and also kinematic. Where kinetic, you are differentiating by compression or stretch. Okay, even in the muscle, it is a contraction. Okay, that is kinetic. In kinematic dysfunctions, we want to differentiate by shortening or lengthening by moving the joint or moving the articular surfaces. Okay. So I thank the previous authors and their works, which has led to development of this clinic, the clinical approach, and also my critics, of course. Okay. So this is the usual thought whenever we treat a patient that we identify the similarity. Okay. A patient comes, we tell, he is ONE only. 3 days back also another ONE I have seen. That is the same presentation. Okay, give the treatment. We tend to see the similarity and then we treat the similarity for various reasons. One is inadequate knowledge. Okay, we don't have that there are different options that are available. So we don't search for the difference. Second one, we tend to take a shortcut, save the time. Okay, in the clinical practice, why do a depth examination? Okay, just to see whatever the common presentation, if it is there, give the treatment. Okay. Third one, of course, you want to show that you are an expert. Okay, if your subordinates are working in your clinical setup, for example, you want to show them that you take a shorter time to diagnose, okay, shorter time to provide a recovery. So go by the major finding and then tell that this patient, it is impingement syndrome. Okay, so just like that, you just arrive at a conclusion. Okay, patient improves, you take the credit. So remember that. We need to differentiate because our hands itself are not similar. Okay. and five fingers of the hand also, it's not similar. Okay. Anatomical basis of differentiation is there. There is physiological basis for differentiation. There is biomechanical basis for the differentiation. And we can utilize that for examination and also planning the treatment using an algorithm. So no two individuals are same, even if identical twins are there. Okay, if both the babies are similar, others will say that the babies are looking absolutely same, but the mother will tell, no, he is Ram, he is Sham. Okay, so remember that there is always a difference. We don't know does not mean that everything is similar. Okay, and research has not explained to prove, okay, that much. But we know examples from nature that there is always a lot of difference between everybody. Okay? And differentiation is essential to individualize the therapy. If, for example, some people are there, they attend a workshop or a certificate course just for 2 days and they become certified practitioners. Okay, so once they become certified myofascial therapy practitioner, they will identify that whatever patients are coming will have myofascial issue problems. Okay, because they'll find only that the similarity between everybody, because they are certified for detecting that similarity. But those who are clinically very dedicated will try to see the difference between each patients, and when they treat the difference, they are actually individualizing the therapy, and the recovery will be special. It's unique to every patient, which you will be able to answer why a particular patient improved better than the other. Okay. So anatomically, you can differentiate in two directions. One is regional differentiation, that is, if shoulder pain is there, differentiate whether the symptom is from cervical spine, or it is from shoulder only, or it is from the elbow. So referred pain, regional interdependence, sometimes thoracic spine mechanics can influence the shoulder mechanics. Our scapular position, shoulder girdle can affect the glenohumeral. And then the next one you see for all the movement testing, you do the active movements, passive movements, and also the resisted isometric test. All of them could be used to identify whether symptom is created only from the shoulder, or when you are doing selective tissue tension to scapula, the shoulder pain is getting reproduced. Okay, then you can tell the probable source could be shoulder girdle, not the shoulder joint. Okay. A structural differentiation within a region where you differentiate between myofascial, articular, neural, or even related vascular tissues. Best differentiation anatomically is the surface anatomy, by which palpation you can identify the structure at fault. But don't just palpate, you do a functional palpation. Okay, utilize the structural anatomy, the function. Surface anatomy, and when you are palpating, you functionally palpate. That means you might compress the joint and then palpate. Okay, you might elongate the joint and then palpate, or you do palpation in the elevated position, palpation in dependent position for articular and venous, or you palpate and then move the area which is far away in order to see for the nerve. Okay, so everywhere you can differentiate. So structurally, you differentiate related adjacent tissues anatomically. Physiological differentiation is basically the mechanisms, which is central and peripheral. If the symptoms are widespread, you can think of central sensitization, okay, non-anatomical tenderness. You palpate everywhere there is tenderness, okay. Then you suspect that the problem is here. And then peripheral mechanisms are very specific to movement testing and also proportionate symptom behavior. That means you do a palpation also, deep pressure, it will pain. And activity also, after some time only, it will provoke the pain. Okay. Not like central mechanism where the pain will be there. Unexpectedly, suddenly the pain comes. Okay, suddenly the pain goes, suddenly the pain comes. Okay, this kind of presentation will indicate central mechanisms. So for the philosophical foundation principles, we need to understand that human body is unique anatomically, physiologically, and biomechanically, where interdependence, okay, is its nature, inherent nature. regions of the body are either correlated or compensated. So when the area becomes abnormal, other region also tries to become abnormal, then it is correlated. Okay? When one is abnormal, other one tries to help that region. Okay, that is compensation. Okay. So if a student is not studying in the class, he is not attentive in the lecture. Okay, the next boy who is sitting, he is also diverting that student. Okay, he is also showing his phone, and then they are discussing. That means it is correlated. Okay, the friend is not attentive to the class, so I tell that, okay, just stay quiet. At least I will listen. Okay, afterwards I can teach you. Okay, that is compensation. Okay. So this kind of situation can happen in our body, and remember that the structures are influenced by activity dependent tensegrity. It's a term which indicates that our daily activities determine what our structures are. Okay, how much they are functionally adaptive. Okay, they can adapt or they can get injured. And then the next one, tensegrity, is the integrity of the tension between various tissues. What is the tension integrity means? Fascia and muscle, there should be tensegrity. Superficial muscle and deep muscle, there should be tensegrity. Between tendon and muscle, there should be tensegrity. Okay. And it could be even capsule versus ligaments, there should be tensegrity. Okay. So all are influenced by our regular activities. We might have one episode of a fall which creates an injury, but that injury, whether it is a fracture or it is a dislocation, okay, it is not just determined by our age, it is also determined by our level of fitness. Okay, if you are sedentary, we might get a fracture for that, okay, rather than getting an ankle sprain, okay, because of the osteoporosis. So movements and forces, that is indirectly what is called as kinematics and kinetics, they regulate the physiology, that is the nutrition, metabolism and the circulation in any structure. Okay, they control this, which is under the control of both the part also and the brain also. That means the peripheral mechanism and the central mechanism. Okay, both are operating for this. And anatomical, physiological and biomechanical continuum is there between. If anatomically it is affected, it will affect the physiology and it will be interpreted in the biomechanical abnormality. Okay, and they are very, very closely interdependent. You treat one approach, the other one will also improve. Okay, you can in our physical examination, physical therapy, what we do, we actually identify the biomechanical, okay, commonly. But what I want you to go into is the physiological, the mechanism, and then the anatomical differentiation, okay, under each of the mechanisms. So this interdependence gets disturbed in any kind of an injury, actual injury or potential injury, okay, and whether it's a minimal injury or maximal injury, will always affect this. And you see that the examination is indicated because activity cannot be same between two individuals. Okay, so activity specific interdependence is always there for that continuum, anatomical, physiological and biomechanical. And the maladaptation is also activity induced, because once we get a symptom, we alter the activity. Okay, what we were doing it normally, usually. After symptom, we do it abnormally. Okay, and that learnt what is called as abnormal thing becomes a normal for us. Okay, so this thing also can happen. That is called as the maladaptation. So that is also there. All are influenced by the activity. Okay, activity does not mean just the type of activity. Activity means that it is the duration of activity, the activity level, the level of activity, okay, everything. A lot of factors are included under the activity. Remember that differentiation examination is a holistic process to identify all types of dysfunctions in orthopedic manual physical therapy. So coming to movement testing. Active movements check the contractile and the inner tissues, whereas passive movements check only the inner tissues. Resisted isometric tests check the contractile tissues. This is part of the Cyriac's concept. When we do the palpation, emphasized on the layer palpation. So you palpate at rest, palpate during a movement, palpate during a contraction. Okay. So you can do static, dynamic, or functional. Functional is during the contraction. Functional is during the compression distraction. Okay, during that you palpate. Functional is when you are palpating at the shoulder, you are moving the neck. Okay, that is also functional for the nerve. Structural differentiation also can be done during the palpation in terms of like nerve, how I have shown. If you are contracting the muscle, okay, during the palpation, okay, that is also a differentiation. You can activate different muscles, upper trapezius versus levator scapulae or supraspinatus, in order to differentiate a symptom at a particular point where all the three muscles are crossing. Okay. So at the superior angle, okay, just lateral to the superior angle of scapula. Mm-hmm. So nerve palpation, yeah, this is actually a video clip to show that cadaver, how we can palpate the nerve. Okay. My fingers are actually on the median nerve. Okay. There are special tests also, which you can utilize to differentiate. An AdSense test or elevated arm stress test is gross differentiation to identify thoracic outlet syndrome. But in that AdSense test, okay, where we take the arm behind an extension, we'll identify pectoralis minor syndrome. A shoulder girdle depression, we'll identify a costoclavicular syndrome. Inspiration and breath holding in the same position. That will indicate actually a Scalenus anticus syndrome. Okay, pardon me for that switch in the sentence there. Okay, so read it as interchanged. Okay, inspiratory breath holding is for Scalenus anticus syndrome, and the cervical rotation opposite side is AdSense. Same side rotation is modified AdSense. Okay, when you are palpating the radial artery pulse and you are keeping the arm behind. Okay, so this rotation of the neck will be maximally producing the symptoms through cervical rib syndromes. Mechanisms, it's a repetition of the central and the peripheral mechanisms. Just for your understanding, to identify that mechanism-based reasoning is very, very important, because we treat the structures, but they respond because of the mechanism only. Okay? We are giving a treatment, whether that particular treatment works or not, it's a mechanism of effectiveness. Okay? So always remember, and whenever there is a symptom or there is a dysfunction, when you are taking history and subjective examination, first to differentiate the physiological differentiation. Because from history, we can see whether it is a central or a peripheral mechanism. And then in the central mechanism, whether it is psychological, which is non-organic, pain plasticity, which is the organic, okay, peripheral, which involves nociceptive and neuropathy. When you are palpating in the earlier part of examination, try to differentiate anatomically first, next to go to regional, and then structural. Okay, so regional ones, palpation of the neck versus palpation of the shoulder, okay, local or referred. Structural palpation, which is neural palpation, myofascial palpation, and articular palpations. Yeah, that again, static, dynamic, and functional, okay, palpation. In the movement testing and in the muscle testing, you will be predominantly concentrating on the biomechanics, where kinetics and kinematics. So compression or stretch or contractions. Kinematics, it is the lengthening or the shortening of the muscle and the muscle play. Remember, this is the treatment-based differentiation. So either one, first option, what you will do. If you identify that the pathology is beyond the scope of physical therapy, you will give a referral to the third party, the physicians, where the condition will be called as red flags. Some of the established red flags are malignancies, infections, fracture dislocations, okay, and systemic diseases like connective tissue disorders like ankylosing spondylitis and rheumatoid arthritis. Okay. In some patients, there is no serious pathologies, but you might find that you should not actually touch the patient now. Okay, either because of too much of pain or it is because of too much of fear about the pain. So there, the patient will be indicated for cognitive behavioral therapy if it is non-organic. The what is called as the yellow flags, psychosocial. Educational interventions are useful for psychosocial category also, or the pain plasticity also. Okay, both the central mechanisms. And especially pain physiology education is indicated for central sensitization. Okay, the pain plasticity, representation of the pain in the brain. Pain relief modalities, you have various options to give: electrical, thermal, mechanical, or manual modalities. Electrical modalities include the low frequency, medium frequency, and the high frequency. Thermal modalities are the cryo or the hot, okay, therapies. Mechanical modalities are like traction, are like continuous passive motions. Okay, they can also give relief. Compression therapy, okay, intermittent compression therapy, lot of all are mechanical modalities. Manual modalities, it is the hands-on treatment directly which can relieve the pain, like positional release techniques, myofascial release techniques. Okay, all of them will relieve the pain. Offloading techniques in the nerve, neuromanual therapy. Okay, stabilization is indicated for instability. The stabilization can be passive stabilization like a collar or a rigid tape. Okay, active stabilization by the motor control training. Mobilization is indicated for hypomobility. So you can do the joint mobilization, you can do the myofascial mobilization, or you can do the neural mobilization. Of course, the last part, don't forget that to return the patient into functional recovery, a good aerobic conditioning and anaerobic conditioning depending upon the demand of the subject, or work-related conditioning because occupational-related injuries, and sports-related conditioning or sports-specific conditioning in athletes and sportspersons. So strength and conditioning forms the last part. This slide is a very, very important slide. All the treatments in physical therapy revolve around this, okay? At least in musculoskeletal physiotherapy. Okay, so it's a differentiation-based clinical decision-making algorithm of the AOMPT. I wish to conclude this presentation by sharing some inspiring quotes. One from Albert Einstein, which says, "Learn from yesterday, live for today, hope for tomorrow. The important thing is not to stop questioning." Okay? A person who do not know the difference between these animals, okay, without differentiation, okay, this is likely to be seen as tall zebra. Because it's actually a giraffe, okay, but a person will tell it's a tall zebra. This obviously, you know, this is an elephant, but the person will see that as hypertrophied zebra, okay, because all that the person knows is only the zebra, okay, so everything will look like a zebra. This is why smudged zebra, because the lines have got smudged. Black and white lines have got smudged in this Jersey cow, which the patient will feel that it is a smudged zebra. Okay. Actual zebra is running. But tiger also will look like a zebra, where the therapist will tell it's a carnivorous zebra. Okay. And finally, they come to the goat. And what do they tell for the goat is atrophied zebra. Okay. So the situation happens because we know only zebra. If we know that it's tiger is like this, elephant is like this, okay, cow is like this, goat is like this, and giraffe is like this, definitely your differentiation will be much better. So I'm not skipping, I'm slipping these slides, because usually these things I tell in what is called as the conference lecture, okay, which I gave it in 2017 in Agartala, TripCon, Tripura. This example usually tells that moment you see these numbers 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay, first thought that comes to our mind is number 4 is missing. Okay, but it's because we have the negativity in our mind. Okay, we see the missing things. But if you see them together, it is 12,35,678. So remember that it is value of seeing together is important. Okay, you might treat the difference between the patients, but don't treat the patient depending upon what is called as their socioeconomic status, or because of their they are referred through your friend, or they are referred by themselves. Okay, don't give that partiality. Okay, you have to treat everyone as the same, but don't treat them as same. Okay, remember that difference between this. Ethics tells that all should be treated equally. Okay, all the patients should be treated equally, but differentiation concept tells that all the patients should not be treated similarly. Okay, there has to be difference in your treatments, either in the dosage or in the direction of combinations. Okay, adjuncts can be different, or it could be what is called as your way of application can be different. Okay, so see the ability and not the disability. See what is there and don't miss what is there. Okay, in the bargain, that rule out what is not there. Commonly in our examination, what we do is we miss what is exactly there. So that should not happen. The moment of thought, so thoughts reap action. Action reaps habit. Habit reaps character. Character reaps destiny. What you sow only, you will reap. Okay. So if you are sowing success, you will reap success. Okay. So make sure that everybody around you, you should promote. You should make them to be successful, so that you also get success. Okay. Practice does not make you perfect. If you practice mistakes, if you are practicing what you have usually learned, you will be perfect in being usual. Okay. So if you are perfectly practicing, you will become perfect. Okay. That is an Indian's word, Shiv Kera. So try to make your efforts so that India is an example of unity in diversity. We have a lot of differences among everybody, but we are all together. Same way, structures are also having their own differences, but they are all together in the same body. Okay? So make sure that your physical therapy contribution should make India proud and also make the world come to India for physical therapy. So I thank the profession of physical therapy, which has given a lot of inputs so that we can evolve newer and newer approaches and concepts in manual therapy and also in examination, which on behalf of Academy of Orthopedic Manual Physical Therapists has registered this approach, differentiation-based physical examination and therapy, as a patient-centered clinical approach. So we have come to the conclusion of the slides. We are ready now. This session is an introductory session, and we have a 10 days package on differentiation based examination. I am emphasizing mainly on the movement testing, okay, with the palpation, okay, how we can actually diagnose and differentially diagnose simultaneously and also separately. So you might see these practical demonstrations. It's fully 100% practical demonstration. I have a model here sitting, and on her I am going to demonstrate directly. Okay, so this 10 days package had a 20% discount. Okay, it has till 25th. Okay, so for all these participants, all of you will be available. What to say? They can avail this discount of 20% and enroll into this 10 days package, so that you can refine and polish your examination skills. If you feel that your examination skills, you don't know anything, okay, or you find that in my presentation I covered too much in a short time and you missed some of it, okay, this presentation alone is available for rupees 100. Okay, you can purchase this video. And then if you want a full physical examination package, it's available for 2500 for 240 videos, which includes anatomy, biomechanics, you have physical examination and then differential diagnosis, all 10 regions. Okay, so you get 10 certificates each region. Okay, anatomy, biomechanics, physical examination, differential diagnosis, cervical spine, next to shoulder, elbow, like that. All videos you will receive immediately after fee payment. The full examination package. There is also a full manual therapy package, which is important because as you want to give treatments, so it might be involving neuromanual therapy, Siriax, myofascial, muscle energy, or the full Maitland concept, and then all the other treatment which techniques which is regionally there. So that is together another 260 videos. That's again 2500, a full fee, okay, for the video course for the 10 regions. So both are available. And on top of that, we have previous webinars which have been successfully conducted during this lockdown. All the webinar packages, the videos are also available for sale. Okay, people can purchase with the certificate to upgrade your skills. Most importantly, it's the end of the lockdown now as we approach. Okay, although the academics is now postponed to 1st November, okay, the UGC notification tells colleges start direct classes from 1st November. So October is also a full month going to be for learning, especially from the AOMPT. Remember that AOMPT is a registered educational institution, okay, which is also ISO approved. It's not a college, okay. It's an educational institution to provide up to certificate level courses. Okay, I can't provide degrees, but we have to go in sync with the policies for every educational institutions. Okay. So, as we wait for queries, I thought I'll give you this closing remarks. Okay. So people who do have more inquisitiveness to learn, kindly take the videos. And the next one is, if you are interested in this topic, definitely don't miss the 10 days package. Okay. It's going to change your whole approach to practice. Arthromyo Neuromanual Therapy, we have two participants, our members, esteemed members, Dr. Pooja and Dr. Ritu, they attended that package. And it's a combined therapy. Okay, we structurally integrate articular, myofascial, and neural at the same time. Okay, simultaneous. And learning from YouTube channels, learning from Facebook. Of course, anyone can watch the YouTube channel, anyone can watch the Facebooks. Okay, but what you learn is only an awareness level of information. Okay, but if you want to learn at a professional level, you have to get access to the videos. And that's why I always ask proof for enrollment also. I want only physical therapists to enroll, okay? So you may not find all the videos in that YouTube channel or the Facebook. Okay? Now also, this webinar I could have easily conducted on Facebook. But what happens is, the moment I conduct on Facebook, people believe that they can watch this video anytime later, okay? So they don't register with me, okay? They are just sitting. We can watch the video anytime. So I get 10 to 15 people who's registering like that. Okay. And in Zoom, only interested people they register. Okay. So, and we know we have a control over the participation, okay, in terms of number, or we can allow them to see or allow them not to see. Okay. Everything is in our control. The Zoom is, okay. In Facebook, it's open. So that's why I did not come live on Facebook. Okay. Of course, I'll come live on Facebook today evening, okay, 5 to 6, to answer queries on differentiation-based physical examination and therapy, okay? So, but those who are attending on Facebook first time, they will not know head or tail of anything. Okay? But those who attended the morning session can also ask their queries in the evening, okay, 5 to 6. Okay, so see you all. Bye-bye. Enjoy the IPL Eve of the COVID-19 lockdown. Good luck to all the physios, and keep doing your best so that you also upgrade to the best, and keep inspiring others to also become the best. Yeah. Good luck, Dr. Pooja, Dr. Ritu, Dr. Gautam, Dr. Manas sir, Dr. Rajesh sir, and Dr. Katyayani is only putting the message. I could not see her. Dr. Sudha is another active candidate, but she is not visible. Either way, Saksham, good luck. Okay, see you. Bye-bye. Dr. Gautam.